Shalom and blessings, my dear friends in Coimbra, Portugal. This week we read all about the passing of Sarah, and the Torah calls it the life of Sarah. Seems a bit ironic. From the dawn of history, people have been searching for a sense of joy, which is as elusive as it is desirable. When Adam and Eve were in the Garden of Eden, in a state of tranquility and spiritual enlightenment, free from worry and hardship, they were unsatisfied and therefore susceptible to temptation of the forbidden fruit. The woman saw the tree was good food and it was delight in her eyes and the tree desirable and wise, and she took part of the fruit and she ate it and she gave it to her husband with her and he ate. This is in Genesis. According to Kabbalah, Eve wanted more than anything was not the fruit per se, but rather the feeling of the objective self. In Eden, there was no place of feeling of the self, only awareness of the divine presence, which the serpent showed Eve, how one could experience a self of self, which created desire. Fulfilling one's desire and pleasures, argued the serpent, is a way to achieve, for joy to be achieved. Unfortunately, experiencing the sense of ego resulted in tragic consequences. In a matter of a few generations, humanity had deteriorated to the world was filled with moral corruption, and God brought about a flood upon the earth. As soon as Noah embarked from the ark, then we read, Noah began, the master of the soil, planted a vineyard and drank the wine and became drunk and then covered himself and went into his tent. Noah was not a simple drunk, as we're finally able to get back to the bottle after a year in the ark. Drinking wine was Noah's attempt to correct the spiritual effects of the tree of knowledge, which brought about moral depravity and ultimately led to the flood. Noah understood that since Adam and Eve were banished from the Garden of Eden, mankind possessed a feeling of self, which among other things focuses their attention on their needs, one's own needs, which led to selfishness, which robbed them from happiness, for ego is never satisfied with what it has. However much it has, it always wants more. Noah wanted to reverse the course of human psychology. He desired to break free of the confines of the ego, and would at least temporarily escape the feeling of self. He hoped by getting drunk would suspend the sense of self and would bring about a bliss and joy. Very quickly, however, Noah learned that route to joy was not the suspension of consciousness through consuming alcohol. The episode did not end well. Then came Sarah, a matriarch. According to Kabbalists, Sarah was the first person to achieve the wholesome experience of a joyous life. She was the first to correct the negative behaviors of Eve and Noah. Sarah understood that the path of joy does not run through the spirit, through the experience of self, like the pleasures of the fruit of knowledge, nor can it be achieved by escaping self-awareness as Noah attempted to do. Sarah understood, while we cannot go back in time and return to Eden, while we cannot liberate ourselves from the sense of self, we can achieve joy by devoting ourselves to something greater than us. When our sense of self is part of a transcendent experience, we're able to escape ego without destroying awareness. As the consequences of the tree of knowledge, God told Eve, in sadness you shall bear children. For the world, there were people who perceive themselves, and there's pleasure and there's also sadness. Yet, many generations later, Sarah understood by devoting oneself to raising a child, devoting oneself for the purpose beyond one's own self, is a model to become holy and achieving joy. Indeed, when Sarah gave birth to her son, who she named Isaac, which means joy, laughter, she modeled the transformation from pain to joy. not only for herself, but also for everyone around us. As the Torah relates, so Sarah said, God has made me joy for me. Whoever hears will rejoice over me. Sarah teaches us that in order to transcend the ego and satisfy joy, one must transcend oneself and become part of a greater story, a greater mission, a mission to make the world a better place by carrying out a divine purpose of creation. Let's hope that we see that happen today. Shalom, my dear friends, in Coimbra, and may we see the wars and all the tragedies end today. Shalom.